In mid-October 2023, Java Platform Group announced the general availability of Oracle's Java Platform extension for Visual Studio Code. Whether you're a beginner or a seasoned Java developer, the extension provides a diverse range of language features and essential programming operations to reduce your efforts when writing, testing, or debugging Java applications. I'm Ana Maria Michalciano, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and I will take you on a short development tour with Oracle's Java Platform extension for Visual Studio Code. Let's start by installing the extension directly from Visual Studio Code by going through Code, Settings, Extensions. If no JDK is present in the system, then the extension can help you obtain one. Go to the Visual Studio Code menu and select View Command Palette, Download, Install, and Use JDK. You can choose to install one of the JDKs listed there or point the extension to the binaries of a JDK existing on your operating system. Be aware that this extension works with minimum JDK 11. Selecting a JDK will update your user settings. If you change your mind and want to use a different JDK, access View Command Palette Preferences, Open User Settings JSON, and manually update JDK Home Setting. You can build, run, and debug your project with the same JDK which runs the Oracle Java Platform extension. The extension searches for a JDK in the following locations: JDK Home, Java Home, JDK Home Environment Variable, Java Home Environment Variable, Current System Path. In case you have a project running on different Java versions, you can associate a profile for each runtime version you use. Once the profile is created, you can customize its settings.json and define there a JDK home value. You can use the command palette to create a new project via View Command Palette Java New Project or open a folder with an existing Maven or Gradle project files. For now, let's create a new Maven project by going through the menu View Command Palette Java New Project and select Java with Maven option. A prompt will ask you to specify a directory where you wish to save your project, for example, concatenate, and then enter a package name. The extension will create a basic pom.xml file and a default directory structure for a Maven project with the source folders defined. The pom.xml file is a single configuration file that contains the majority of information required to build a project. Next, let's explore the generated project. You can visualize your project in Visual Studio Code Explorer. The goal of the concatenate project is to provide intersection of two lists. This program aims to receive the lists as arguments and calculate their intersection. In addition to Visual Studio Code Explorer, the Oracle Java Platform extension offers the Project Explorer that contains an overview of the project structure. You can use it to clean, compile, test, debug, and execute your Maven or Gradle Java projects. Speaking of debugging and launching an application, let's check out how you can try and customize those. The Oracle Java Platform extension launch configuration supports debugging and running Java applications using minimum JDK 11. You can invoke the launch configuration or the debugger when you select Run Main Debug Main Code Lines or from the Run and Debug Activity panel. A range of actions is supported: pause, step over, step into, step out, restart, stop and disconnect. In the Run and Debug view, you can customize your launch configurations by choosing Java from the drop-down list and then click the Run icon. Default launch configurations are available in the launch.json file, but you can also attach debugger actions by selecting either from available processes or enter the port to connect to the JVM running with the Java DebugWire protocol. On Windows operating system, you can also select Attach to Shared Memory. If you want to modify the program arguments, virtual machine options, environment variables, or set the working directory, just go to Run Configuration panel of the Explorer view. For example, you can run your application with arguments by adding them to program arguments. The extension can also assist you when writing documentation by suggesting to insert pre-formatted and pre-populated javadoc comments. Just type slash and two stars above a method signature, and the IDE will offer to complete the javadoc. The action creates a javadoc comment with all arguments prepared. Now that we wrote and run this piece of code, let's see how we can test it. You can generate a test via show code lightbulb and select create test class option. The generated test class will contain methods that are either empty or failing. Let's focus on modifying one of the generated tests to validate extra common elements method. Next, let's go to the Extensions Test Explorer view, which allows us to run all tests in a project, examine the results, go to source code, and run a particular test. While tests help you gain confidence that you contribute to building bug-free applications, you can perform refactorings to improve the quality of a software without breaking its functionality for end users. To maintain a Java application usually means to improve internal code by making many small changes without altering its functional requirements. For example, if you're using JDK 21 or later, you can select get of index 0, right-click, and change all occurrences to use sequence collection method get first. More refactoring suggestions are available via show code lightbulb and refactor context menu. To speed up development, you can use the source action context menu to generate methods for your class or organize imports in Java sources. You can enhance import optimization strategy by going to VS Code View, Command Palette, Preferences, Open User Settings, Extensions, Java, and search for JDK to set the JDK Java imports options. Class counting to use a star import with 1999 as the default value. Members count to use a static star import having 99 as the default value, and groups of import statements specified by their package prefixes and their sorting order. The IDE can also organize imports when you save a document. You can enable this option via View, Command Palette, Preferences, Open User Settings, Extensions, Java, On Save, Organize Imports, and tick the checkbox. You can achieve more complex refactorings, like changing the parameters of a method via a dedicated form that allows you to change add, remove method parameters. In case you decide to move members from a class to another one, you can do so from Refactor Move Context menu. Besides the already mentioned refactorings, here are some more supported strategies. As we conclude this exploration of the Oracle Java Platform extension for Visual Studio Code, I encourage you to give it a try and integrate it in your development process. Moreover, this is an open source project, so community contributions and feedback are welcomed. Check the contribution guide and join our effort to offer a smooth developer experience with Java. If you enjoyed this video, kindly help me by letting YouTube know. See you soon!